In an earlier video, I dealt with an application of solving logarithm equations having to do with astronomy. That application involved the equation that you see here, the capital M equals little m minus 5 times the logarithm of d over 32.6. In this equation that we have here, the capital M is the absolute magnitude of a star. And that happens to be how bright it appears at a particular distance. In the previous video, I didn't mention that that particular distance happened to be 32.6 light years. There's a reason for that if you really want to know. Take astronomy. The lowercase m is the apparent magnitude of the star, and that's just how bright it appears in the night sky of Earth. And then the lowercase d up there is the distance to the star in light years. In that previous video, we solved this equation for the distance. There are ways to determine the absolute magnitude of a star. We can always determine the apparent magnitude just by looking at it. But there are ways to determine the absolute magnitude of a star without knowing the distance to it. And if you do that, then you can actually solve for the distance to the star. And we went through the steps of doing that solution. I'll just write down the solution here. When we solve that equation for the distance, we get that d is equal to 32.6 times 10 to the little m minus capital M divided by 5. So I'd like to do an example that uses that. Let's suppose we look at a star, and just by looking at it, we find out that the apparent magnitude, m, is 5.05. By some means, we determine that its absolute magnitude is minus 8.73. The magnitude scale is such that stars can actually have negative magnitudes, and it's also set up in such a way that the smaller or the more negative the magnitude of a star is, the brighter it happens to be. This would actually be quite a bright star if you had one like this. But with these two values for the apparent and absolute magnitude, we could set up our equation, and I'm just going to take this equation here and plug the numbers into it. D is equal to 32.6 times 10 raised to the little m minus capital M. That would be 5.05 minus a negative 8.73. All of that over 5. And then I close off my parentheses there. You can do this calculation by plugging it straight into your calculator, but I'm going to simplify it a bit before I do that to keep our presentation simple here. First of all, 5.05 minus a negative 8.73 is going to be 5.05 plus 8.73, and that will equal. Should be 13.78. Okay, and then the other part of our exponent is taking that 13.78 and dividing by 5. And when we do that, 2.756, I can actually keep four significant figures on here because of the rules of significant figures. That 5 is an exact integer, actually, so I can keep that. Anyway, my distance to the star is now going to be 32.6 times 10 to the 2.756. That exponent looks a little frightening. You've probably never seen one like that, but it's comparable to a fractional exponent, and your calculator will have no trouble dealing with that. In fact, I'm going to write down the steps that you'll do on your calculator here. 32.6, hit the multiplication button, times. Then, to get that 10 to the power, It's a couple of keystrokes. You do the second key and the log key in sequence. You may notice above the log key it has a 10 to the x there. When you get through this part of the calculation, your display will show something. 32.6. There's an asterisk showing, which indicates multiplication. Then a 10 and a little caret symbol. That indicates exponentiation. It indicates that the thing after the caret is an exponent, and it also introduces a left parenthesis for you. So now it's time to put in that 2.756. When you do that, the display will show 32.6 times 10 caret 2.756, and we need to finish off the display or finish off the exponent, so you put in a right parenthesis, and then all that happens is you just get a right parenthesis added on after all that other stuff. And then you hit the equal sign. I happen to have my calculator in scientific notation right now, and so the result I get on mine is it shows 1.858, and then there's a whole bunch of other junk. Let's see, 73 dot 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 times 10 to the fourth, or if you don't have it in scientific notation, it may be written as 18,587.3 3553 or something like that, but most of that's garbage. I can only keep three significant figures because the 32.6 that I multiplied it by is only good to three significant figures. So the best I could do is to write this as 1.86 times 10 to the fourth or 18,600, and it'll be that distance in light years. Let's do another example here. Let's suppose we have a star for which the apparent magnitude is 3.06, and this would be a number that you can get more or less just by looking at it through a telescope. And through some means, someone determines that the absolute magnitude of it is 7.79, and we want to figure out the distance to it. Again, we'll use this equation here, and when we do that, we will get d equals 32.6 times 10 to the 3.06 minus 7.79 all over 5, and that's what we would evaluate. We could do that on a calculator in one single stretch of keystrokes, but I'm going to evaluate that exponent first off to the side here. 3.06 minus 7.79 over 5. When I do the subtraction, I would get a minus 4.73 over 5, and that happens to be minus 0.946. I'll have to be careful when I put that into my calculator. So the equation that I've got over here now becomes 32.6 times 10 to the minus 0.946. Here are the keystrokes I use to do that. I start off as I did before, 32.6 times, and now I need to exponentiate that 10, so I do what I did before, the second button and the log button. And when I do that, my display will show 32.6, an asterisk to indicate multiplication, and a 10 caret and a left parenthesis. So the next thing coming will be the exponent that's up there. It's negative. Now, on some calculators and some TI calculators, this is the case. If I were to hit the minus sign, it would think I'm doing the operation of subtraction and things might get fouled up. But there's a way to do this to show this minus sign on the exponent without hitting the minus sign. I have to hit something special for that, and that's the key just to the left of the equal sign. That's a little minus sign with parentheses wrapped around it, and then I would put in the 0.946 946. To finish off the exponent, I'd hit a right parentheses. And when I'm done with this, I'll have this in my display. I'll have 32.6, that asterisk, 10 caret, left parentheses. There's a little slightly different looking minus sign that shows in the display, which is barely noticeable. And then the 0.946 and a right parentheses. And my number is entered at this point. All I have to do is hit the equal sign down there, and I'll get my result. My result in this case happens to be D equals 3.69. And so this would be a star that's only 3.69 light years away. Turns out there aren't any stars that close. However, in the past at some point or in the future, there will probably be a star that happens to be that distance away from it. Thus, it may not have these particular magnitudes, but that might be the result of a future or past calculation. Okay, those are a couple of examples of using a logarithm equation for an astronomical application.